Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, I'm going to do a little bit of VBA, and this tip is actually sent along by John. John was at our Power Analyst Boot Camp in Chicago and just sent me a note last week with this tip. He has gone to Excel 2007 and found something very annoying, and I just want to point that out. But along the way, I'm going to show you a cool thing in Excel. If we were setting up a named range, so let's say that we have this cell in Excel, and we would want to set up a named range, I'm going to turn on the macro recorder. Tools, macro, record new macro, and I'll click OK. To create a named range, the fastest way is just to go to the name box and type a new name. So we'll call this, let's say, revenue, and press enter. Now I'll stop recording, and we'll go take a look at that macro to see how the macro recorder recorded that code. So I'll click edit, and it uses this code, activeworkbook.names.add. Name is revenue, refers to, in R1C1 style, which I know drives a lot of people crazy, row 1, column 2. Well, that's how the macro recorder does it, but it really is a long way around. The much faster way to go is just to say, hey, we're going to take range cell B1 dot name equals revenue. So just using the dot name property is a much faster way to create a name. We can actually get rid of this code here, and when we run our macro, tell you what, let me change it to a different cell just to prove that it's working. So we'll go to C3. When we run this macro, very quickly we've made C3 be the name revenue. Now, here's the tip from John. John likes to use named ranges, and he uses short named ranges. For example, ROI 2007 or Tax 82. When you use names like that, that causes a real problem when you go to Excel 2007, because in Excel 2007 with 16,000 columns, we now have column names that go out from AA to ZZ and then start over at AAA out to XFD. So a lot of those names that used to work in Excel 2003, ROI 2007, is now a cell address, and when you try and assign that name in Excel 2007 VBA, it fails. So John had all of this code that was working in Excel 2003, but because he used three-digit names followed by a number, he ran into all sorts of problems and all sorts of recoding. So even if you're still sitting here in Excel 2003, think ahead and make sure that you don't use three-letter range names, because eventually, someday, you're going to upgrade to the new Excel, whether it's Excel 2007 or Excel 14 or 15 or 16, and at that point, those three-digit range names will no longer work. So let's make your code a bit more flexible now to save you a lot of hassle in the future. Hey, thanks for stopping by, and thanks to John for sending in that tip. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.